Hey guys, welcome back. I am just now starting my Ultimate Star Wars Marathon with Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. I'm also going to be live tweeting during this time, so... Well, I'm going to try and live tweet anyway. I've never done this before. So, here we go. This is going to be fun. My dad watched this not that long ago, but... I think this is going to be a lot of fun. I love this movie. All right. Episode 1. The Phantom Dentist. I mean Menace. Turmoil has engulfed the Galactic Republic. The taxation of trade routes to outlying star systems is in dispute. That's a tongue twister. Hoping to resolve the matter with a blockade of deadly battleships, the greedy Trade Federation has stopped all shipping to the small planet of Naboo. While the Congress of the Republic endlessly debates this alarming chain of events, the Supreme Chancellor has secretly dispatched 2 Jedi Knights, the Guardians of Peace and Justice in the galaxy, to settle the conflict.
I have a bad feeling about this. I don't sense anything.
I knew it. They're here to force a settlement.
Force a settlement? Oh, no pun intended, right? My lord. Who's that?
Is that
legal? They never bothered a politician before whether or not something's legal. By the way, that's what the animators said when they saw George's storyboards. This is impossible!
They've gone up the ventilation shaft.
Ducts. Why is it always ducts? Wait a minute. Wrong movie. This shot is really pretty. I'm still noticing new things every time I see it. Sound of a thousand terrible things headed this way. If they find us, they will crush us, grind us into tiny pieces, and then blast us into oblivion. I like that line. Oh, if he had done that at the Olympics, he would have gotten a 10 easy. Look, Jar Jar is standing there, he doesn't have any weapons, and the guard zaps him anyway. How wooed does not even begin to cover that. That is... I would call that enforcement brutality right there. He's standing there not doing anything, and he gets zapped. Yeah, okay, fine, get him out of here. You know, in the novelization, the original script, when they ask what was going to be done with Jar Jar, they said pounded unto death. So, I think they're even now. Qui-Gon saved Jar Jar's life after Jar... Yeah. Well, you know what? They saved his life twice. Okay. So, yeah.
It's a long potato, but a small part of it would be Miss, clumsy.
Same.
You're banished because you're clumsy.
You're so much, Miss.
Yep. Poor Jar Jar. I can relate to him so much. Hello. It's like a crayfish crossed with a lobster, and maybe a shrimp, and an anglerfish. It's funny, is I wonder if Jar Jar senses it, because he's just sitting there as calm as all get out, and there's danger right behind him. Oh. Oh gosh. Poor Jar Jar. Huge O teeth! Boy, here it is.
There's always a bigger fish.
There's always a bigger fish. I love that line. Premature celebration. In my literal mind, that brings up some very disturbing images. Sound a gift. Yeah, Jedi cut them down like they're butter. They're pretty useless.
Get their weapons.
Use a guy's bomb bat. I love it. Let's see. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think 6 R2 units, maybe up to 8, because there's bays for up to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oof, good grief, down to half already.
We're losing droids fast.
Oh yeah.
We can't get the shield generator fixed, we'll be sitting ducks.
What's a duck?
Shield
droid. And of course, R2 is always the one to save the day. One of the reasons why I love R2. Seeing little Anakin always, it gives me a weird mixture of warm fuzzies and this wistful feeling because we know what ends up happening to him. Ugh, it's sad.
Don't touch anything.
Oh, my fiance does a really, really good Watto impression.
No, they won't.
It's like spot on.
They won't. What, do you think you're some kind of Jedi waving your hand around like that? I'm a toy that is.
Mind tricks don't work on me. Only money.
No money.
The Queen's wardrobe, maybe, but see the basket. Not in the amount she's talking about. All right. Sure.
Well, you don't know how much fancy fabrics bring on Tatooine. Everybody out there has got homespun.
No, I can't. No, I can't. The beans you're about call way.
That's how that's like where I grew up. That's relatable. I have nothing of value. Okay. Oh, by the way, that silver thing in the background, that is a dog tug toy. Our dog used to have one of those. They were popular in the late 90s. It was like made out of solid rubber. And the other toy behind him is like a toss and catch thing. Like almost like lacrosse, but they took some random toys, spray painted them silver. Oh, okay, random parts from Star Wars.
A pleasure to meet you.
The public doesn't exist out here.
Mm.
We must survive in our lives.
When you're in the outskirts of civilization, laws don't always work because it's so far flung that there's hardly anybody around to enforce them. I love this almost parental connection that Qui-Gon develops with Anakin right off. I keep wondering, like, if Qui-Gon hadn't... I keep wondering what would have happened to Anakin if Qui-Gon had been the one to actually train him. Ooh! Fanfiction plot buddy, I'm gonna need to write that down. Someday. I would love it if Qui-Gon pops up again in the Obi-Wan Kenobi series. We've got a Shmi in the local chapter of the Rebel Legion, and she is an absolute sweetheart. Did anybody ever watch the TV show Zoom, either in the 70s or the 90s? They had a language called Ubby Dubby, where you put UB, before every single vowel, or at least between the consonants and the vowels. That's what it sounds like Jar Jar speaking. It sounds like he's speaking Ubby Dubby. It's interesting. In the book, Master and Apprentice, Obi-Wan was sort of talking about some of Qui-Gon's almost like a moral ambiguity in some instances. Like he's willing to break rules if it benefits somebody. Qui-Gon cheated. I mean, he cheated to let the die fall so Anakin could be freed. But because he knew in the long run that was the right thing. It wouldn't be right to leave Anakin without his mother on Tatooine. But Anakin has had a better future training, or at least learning how to control the powers that he was born with, so. Ha! Irony. My brother used to have the pod racing video game for the Nintendo 64, and he also had it on PC for a while. But at one point, I had all the names of every single pod racer in this scene memorized, but I completely forgot since. These pit droids are like the Three Stooges. I wonder which one's Moe, Larry, and Curly. If I ever have a blonde little boy, I want to dress him up as Anakin when he's like 8 or 9. Well, there's Jabba. I think that may be Gardula behind him. I'm not sure. Woo! I remember every time my family watched this, my brother during the pod race, when the one came up the middle, he'd duck. I believe this area is called Mushroom Mesa. Some of those by the way, most of the background plates for the pod race, I think most, if not all of them, were taken in Utah, which is sweet. Those arches look really familiar, too. That guy I feel sorry for because his whole family was watching. Like, oh, that's just... that poor little guy. Okay, I have to... I wonder if he's a Pantoran or something. Oh, that sucks. And there are those frogs. How can a desert planet like Tatooine have so many frogs? Do they have like underground springs or something? What the heck? Are they imported off-world? They seem to be everywhere, so I don't think they're imported. I remember that guy. He's like Gazgano or something. This guy sounds like Animal from the Muppets. Sounds like Animal. I don't care what universe you're from. That's gotta hurt. Back across Mushroom Mesa with all the hoodoos. Hoodoo? You do. Do what? Remind me of the Babe with the Power. Wait, wrong movie. Oh, here we go. I like this. There it is. I don't know why I find Houdini so funny. I wonder if anybody has done a mashup of Sebulba and Anakin getting caught together and the two speeder bike engines getting caught together in Return of the Jedi. And done like a comparison, because this, you know, I know George mentioned it's like poetry, they rhyme, but still, it's like, it's the same thing happens. Even with everything that's happened in the other episodes in the saga, this still makes the top 10 list for saddest moments in Star Wars. And the Force theme coming in. I just keep thinking about, he did see her again, but when he saw her again, she died in his arms, so. Ouch. Anakin got run over by a Sith Lord, running to our ship on Tatooine. I can't take credit for that, by the way. That's been around for a few years. Woohoo! The only thing I can think of is how dang hot Ray Park would have been lightsaber fighting in the Tunisian desert in like 120, 130 degree heat. Yikes. Even as a younger senator, Palpatine still kind of creeps me out. That skyline, I swear it looks like a cross between New York and Chicago, but on steroids. I can't remember if that's a Gotal or... Bothan that's driving the air taxi. It looks like a toaster. It seriously looks like a toaster. Let's see. I'm trying to remember the names of the entire Jedi Council. Okay, Plo Koon, Mace Windu, Yoda, Ki Adi Mundi. I'm glad they don't have the bad puppet Yoda here. Okay. Ki Adi Mundi, who else? Okay, Eeth Koth, Yaddle, Oporansesis. I can't remember the dude with the scar over his eye. Adi Galia. I can't remember the dude with the stretched neck either. I used to have every single member of the Jedi Council, their name, I had all their names memorized. I can't remember all of them now. That was Eeth Koth and Depa Bilaba, I think. Actually, Depa Bilaba, I think Depa Bilaba is actually Kanan Jarrus's master. And those floating camera droids, they look like Weebo from Flubber. Wookiees. There's E.T. Oh! They took out the vote now. Said the spider to the fly. One of the biggest flaws of the Jedi in the Old Republic was their arrogance in thinking, oh, there's no more Sith. We got rid of all the Sith Lords. Like they couldn't possibly rise again. And their inflexibility, trying to shove everybody into a box. And that's actually the thing I dislike most about public education is throwing everybody into a box. And not everybody fits in a box. And there's Anakin. He must have heard Obi-Wan say the boy is dangerous. What must that have done to a 9-year-old kid's psyche, and now the kid feels guilty.
Qui-Gon, sir. I don't want to be a problem.
There it is. There's the Wilhelm. Oh, those yellow eyes. Those creep me out.
We'll take the long way.
To this day, I see anybody dressed as Darth Maul, and they look that good. I shudder so much. I'm like, ugh. The double-bladed lightsaber is something I wish they'd kept secret until the film. If they hadn't revealed it in the trailer when that second blade ignited in the theater, everybody would have been going nuts. Well, they went nuts anyway. They're like, whoa. They're like, ah, they cheered when the second blade ignited. Oh, man. Oh. That's a maneuver I want to learn how to do. I think it's called like a butterfly kick or something. It's sort of like, it's almost like a cartwheel, only you're, instead of going upside down, it's almost like an aerial cartwheel, but instead of going upside down like that, your legs sort of flip off to the side like that, and then you land. I need to learn how to do that. Woo! I still geek out over that. Ah, man, it's so crazy. No. How did he survive? I mean, look, he was cut in half at the waistline. There are like, there's a whole bunch of vital organs below that. And also he fell down a bottomless pit. He should not have survived. Yes, he's a cool character, but he should not have survived that injury.
And you, young Skywalker, we will watch your career with great interest.
Ugh. Somebody keep that guy away from... Ugh. He's standing right there! Oh, man. I keep looking for Mark Hamill's son, Nathan, but I have not been able to find him anywhere. I probably have to freeze frame it and then zoom into every single person's face in order to find him. And Iris out. All right. That has been the Clumsy Jedi reacting to episode 1. The Phantom Menace. Tomorrow, I get to watch episode 2 again. So, here we go. Question of the day. Which part of The Phantom Menace is your absolute favorite? Go ahead and post a comment. So, I'll see everybody again tomorrow, and until then, God bless, and may the Force be with you. Bye!